Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Harsha's Academy. Today we are going to learn about bar chart. Now basically this bar chart is useful in construction scheduling when you have to schedule different activities. See, on construction site there are different activities or various activities which on which you have to focus. So bar chart will help you to determine how much time each activity will take and what will be the total duration of the project. So this bar chart was given by Henry Gantt. That's why it is also called as Gantt chart. Now, this bar chart is represented on simple graph paper, taking all the activities on y-axis and duration on x-axis. So, suppose this will be your duration on x-axis. And on y-axis, you have to take your activities first. Now, which activities you will take? First, you have to divide the whole project into number of sub-activities. Suppose one construction project I have, and I am dividing the activities like brickwork, plastering, electrification, plumbing, tiling work, painting, likewise. So, you have to, in bar chart, you have to start first activity at the top. So, suppose, and also you should know what is the duration required for each activity. Suppose brickwork is having duration 7 days. Then plastering, let it be again 7 days. Then plumbing, 5 days. Likewise, this much data you should have. Now from this data you have to draw the graph. So suppose first activity is your brickwork. So, here 1, 2, likewise, you have to show the duration in days, in weeks, in years, so on. So, this is your first activity. Why it is called as bar chart? Because we are showing this bar, that's why it is called as bar chart. Now, first activity is your brickwork having duration 7 days. Let I am assuming 1 centimeter is equal to 5 days, let it be. This is my scale and let it be, this is my first activity, brickwork. Now second is your plastering. I have to see on that particular schedule that my plastering will start simultaneously or after the completion of whole brickwork. So likewise, I will draw the next activity. Suppose after finishing 3 days works of brickwork, I will start my plastering work. So let it be, this is the, let this activity is your plastering. Then plumbing. Plumbing I'll start after finishing of plastering. So this is your plumbing activity. In this way, you have to show all the activities into the bars. And if you, suppose last activity is your painting, external painting. Okay. This is your external painting. So here you will come to know what is the total duration required to complete all those activities. This is the simple bar chart given by Henry Gantt, where this method is only implemented when the project is small. If the project having less activities or small duration, there only we can implement this method given by Henry Gantt, that is also called as bar chart. Thank you. Please like and share my videos. Also subscribe to my channel. Thank you.